Okay, here is the details, the full details about good straightening process. So you should know that this process is always initiated by the customer. Okay, customer must be the one who should first know he or she wants to return goods, right? So for sure, it is customer who initiates this goods returning process. This goods returning process, there are two stages. First stage is where the customer would send two things to the supplier. One is the goods to be returned along with the debit note back to the supplier. Okay, so it's logical that the goods that need to be returned will be sent to the supplier. Then, what is the purpose of having this debit note? The debit note's purpose is to request for reduction in the previously received invoice. Okay, that means if the customer send the goods to be returned without the debit note, if the customer sends the goods to be returned without the debit note, it would be assumed that customer doesn't want to seek deduction. Okay, it will assume that customer doesn't want to seek deduction if debit note is not sent. So that's the reason you need to have the debit note. Debit note is used to request for a deduction in the earlier invoice. Okay, so you can see that there's an amount written next to it, $30. $30. That's the amount customer wants to request to be deducted in the earlier invoice. Okay, due to the goods return. Okay. A request is not always accepted. A request is not always accepted or fully accepted. So we can say that this $30 is an unconfirmed amount to be deducted. Unconfirmed. That's the reason you never record debit note. Because that's an amount requested to be deducted. So it's unconfirmed. Therefore, we never record debit note. We never record a debit note. Regardless of whether you are supplier or customer, we never record debit note. That's the first stage of the goods returning process. Okay, and then the second stage is where the supplier receives the goods to be returned and the debit note. And then supplier for sure must check the goods condition. After that, supplier would make a confirmation, okay, to confirm how much he or she would like the customer to deduct an amount in the invoice. So it confirms by sending a credit note to the customer. Okay, you can see this amount is different from the amount requested. It's only $28. Why? What could be the reason? Is less than the amount requested? Okay, let me write an example of reason for you here. It could be that customer has caused some fault to the goods. Okay, customers have caused some fault to the goods. That's the reason suppliers doesn't approve the full amount to be deducted. Okay, instead of approving $30 to be deducted, supplier only approved $28. Okay, so write down this example of reason. Customer could have caused some fault to the goods. That's the reason the amount allowed to be deducted is only 28, not 30. So what is the purpose of a credit note? You have to write this line in the exam to confirm the amount that can be allowed to be deducted in the previously issued invoice. That's the answer. Okay, so there you go, the two stages of goods returning process. Okay, about recording into accounting, we don't record debit note, but we only record the credit note. Whether you are the supplier or customer, you would record this event, this goods returning event, based on the credit note only. Okay, so very soon you are going to see how we record a credit note as an evidence of the goods returning process.